In this episode, we're identifying the proper arrangement of your system memory and determining exactly how to install it. Stick around.
You're watching IT Pro TV.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for tuning in to more of the hands-on PC build. That's right. Today is all about our system memory. And really, I have to start out with saying that, you know, if you're going to install your system memory and populate all of the DIMM slots, every DIMM slot that you have on the motherboard, then some of the things that I'm going to say aren't really going to apply to you. I would just give you a piece of advice. Make sure that it's the same vendor, the same make and model across all of the DIMM slots so that you get the performance that you need. However, let's take a look at the bench here, and we have a couple of sticks. We've got a two DIMM module set here. Notice that it says right there, it says 2 × 8 GB. It's a 16 gig kick, but it's only 2 memory modules, right? So in order to take advantage of what's known as dual channel memory architecture, in this case, really any multi-channel architecture, whether it's dual channel, triple channel, quad channel, you want to make sure that you pay attention first to the vendor specifications and make sure that you install them in the appropriate positions on the motherboard. Now, like I said, as a reminder, if you're going to populate all of the DIMM slots on the motherboard, that's okay. Just make sure same memory, same vendor, same speed, make, and model, and you'll be okay. However, if we're going to leave some of these open, we want to make sure that we use both of the channels or more than a single channel to get the total performance out of the memory that we want. So to kind of show you what I'm talking about here, let's take a bird's eye view. And one of the things you're going to see here on our motherboard is the fact that we've got a little bit of a color coding, and I'm going to go a little bit farther than that too. Notice that we've got some gray, and we've also got some black DIMM sockets or slots on the motherboard here. Notice we got 2 gray and we got 2 black. All right. Now, I also want you to pay attention to the markings that we have right here, because you'll see they all say DDR4, but notice that there is a B and there's A. We got B1, B2, we got A1, and A2. Now, I'm going to refer to these as positions across all 4 of these DIMM modules. This first position right here that we see, that's B1. The second position here, that's B2. The third position, that's A1. And then the fourth position, that's A2. Now, let's pay attention to the numerical value. Notice that B1 and A1 are the gray slots on the motherboard, all right? Notice that B2 and A2 are the black DIMM slots on the motherboard, all right? These represent the individual dual channels. The gray slots are, let's say, channel 1, right? That's B1 and A1. The black slots, positions 2 and positions 4, that's our second channel, which would line up to B2 and A2. All right, now, when we go to install these memory modules, since we're not populating all 4 of them, we want to pick which color here we want to pair these up with. Now, I'm going to go ahead, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose the B2 and then the A2. And you might notice that right here we've taken off the fan cover because it gives us a little bit more room to work with. So what do you say we go ahead and we're going to take our RAM modules, and I'm going to take the very first one out. I do have my anti-static wrist strap on, and that's very important. Remember, as we've told you, you want to take the necessary precautions to avoid any static discharge. And you'll also notice that I'm holding on to the sides of the board here. I'm not holding on directly to any of the circuitry because I don't want to leave the oils in my hands on this PCB or the printed circuit board because they're very caustic. And what we'll do is we'll take this one and we'll go ahead and we'll install that in the first position. Now that, or the, I should say second position. Remember, that's B2. And I'm gonna just open these up here. And then what we'll do is we'll just gently put our memory module in there, and you'll hear it click into place, and notice that the tabs lock around the memory. That means that this is inserted appropriately and that module is ready to go. The next thing that we're going to do is we'll take, remember our A2 position. I'll go ahead and while we're looking at it, I'm going to open these up. And what do you say? We go ahead and we'll take our second memory module. Again, being mindful of things like electrostatic discharge. Again, when I'm holding this memory module, notice that I'm not actually touching the circuitry. We don't want to do that. And what we'll do is we'll just come down here and we'll just install this in that final position here. And again, just gently rocking it back and forth until you feel the little latches click into place because they're grabbing the side of the memory. Now, what we've done here is if I decide that I want to go back and I want to install, let's say, and populate all of these, then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and I'm going to get another two module 16 gig kit, and I will get the same one. Crucial, it'll be your DDR4, and that'll be the 2666 to make sure, or 2666 to make sure that it matches what we already have in here. So ladies and gentlemen, there you go. What we had to do here is we had to identify the appropriate arrangement to make sure that we're taking advantage of the multi-channel architecture, and then finally determining how to install your system memory.
Thank you for watching IT Pro TV.